Hello, this is Mrigank Warrior, Assistant Editor in the Clean India Journal, and I'm in conversation with Dr. Anusha Rohit, Consultant and Head of Infection Control at the Madras Medical Mission Hospital, Chennai, and Mr. Narayanan Raghavan, CEO of Rent-A-Towel, a linen management company that focuses on the rental model for linen management. We're going to be in conversation about the association between linen management, laundry, hygiene, and infection control in the hospital scenario.
A hospital is, one place where laundry is reused amongst various patients, and hence they can be a source of infection to many patients. Now, if we talk about the organisms precisely as your question states, I would think that, though this is not really spoken about, what is very clear is that the human body sheds a lot of epithelial cells and the skin microorganisms as the patient is admitted in the hospital, even with minimal activity when the patient is lying down for it. These organisms essentially are, those that can be found on the laundry. And though there is no real outbreak-like situation that we're talking about, because the skin is only in contact with the patient's intact skin, except for burns patients and all of those, but essentially otherwise it's on intact skin, there is no direct, it's not like a smoking gun of saying, this is going into the intravenous site. But nonetheless, it is helping colonization. And eventually, since that is the source of many infections, say, for example, we have to have a centerline, inserted, that is going to be on an intact skin of the patient, which, if not adequately disinfected, can be a source of infection. In the high throughput areas like the ER and the places where patients are, constantly moving around, like for example the CCU, we use disposable sheets because we cannot have that amount of turnover. Our laundry services are outsourced, due to which we cannot have that sort of turnover. So we use, once a use kind of disposable laundry only in these high throughput areas, because routinely we are using the cloth as a, the one that is reused, washed and reused.
People do not give much importance to the processing of the healthcare linen using the barrier washes, and also the CFU count that needs to be maintained at the laundry level has to be enforced by the healthcare authorities, so that the hygiene part of it is taken care of the processing of the linen, and the healthcare linen should be processed in a separate environment. And it should not be mixed with other fabrics. There has to be some kind of a certification process for these laundries, where you maintain certain levels of criteria for, the microorganisms present in this, aerobic content in the present in the laundry, the CFUs in the laundry. All these needs to be vetted at frequent intervals, and there has to be a mandate from the health authorities and the municipalities to make sure that the healthcare linen is processed at a better environment than the hospitality industry. The traces of the virus sits on the 100% cotton fabric for a longer time than the polycotton blended fabric. So people are now moving towards 100% cotton, which was comfortable, and because it had so many other, features in it. And now people started moving towards something which is blended.
Unlike hospitals which are not under the accreditation process, because when you're accredited, you have to have certain basic, criteria to be able to pass through accreditation, especially from HIC. So it is mandated that we visit a laundry facility every 6 months to 1 year, and there's a specific checklist. So we also have an outsourced facility for our laundry. As far as fabric is concerned. Generally, we are not looking at what the fabric is, but when it is laundry that is stained with, say, excreta of the patient, urine, vomitus, or blood stains, we have a separate process of dipping it in hypochlorite. Now, the problem that we used to face when we dipped it with hypochlorite is that the strength of the fibers are, you know, lost, and the tears happen very, very easily. You know, the laundry management to also have a higher temperature at which they their washing cycles are for the contaminated linen in comparison to the, you know, the routine linen that is used. Tell the staff not to kind of dust it out in the air so that we don't have, you know, these skin particles and organisms flying all over the air. The PPE that they're asked to wear are a mask and gloves, generally. And we ask them not to touch their body with the linen during the folding process, for example. So these are the small things that we do. We also use a higher cycle temperature of the cycle during the wash.
Contact, the physical contact with the linen, as Dr. mentioned just now, has to be avoided. So this can be done by putting the RFID wash tags in each of these linen. And for the sake of counting it, it can be from a distance where you scan the linen and then it is sent off to the laundry washing. Process of washing these healthcare linen has to be much more serious and severe at all the laundries where they process the healthcare linen. First of all, it has to be a dedicated healthcare processing linen processing facility. There cannot be a mix of linen with the hospitality industry linen. There are different kinds of process, as doctor said, that hypochlorite is one process where, you know, we dip the contaminated linen into that for a certain amount of hours and then we process it. The chemistry of the healthcare processing linen has to be different from the hospitality linen. The antimicrobial linen, the chemicals which are produced from Dow Chemicals of US, and we use it in the final rinsing process. And the linen is to be kept, after the washing is done, it has to be kept in an open air for the linen to breathe. Keep the linen to breathe and then put it back into operation. So this is where, you know, there is a possibility of virus and fungus, bacteria, which can sit on the linen itself if it is not allowed to breathe and put back into the operation.
When the laundry comes in. All right. So we are just assuming that the process is complete because the way it is packed and brought back, and it is a supplier that we've gone and evaluated their process. And like he said, it is a dedicated facility only for a hospital, you know, increase our number of, all of these laundry material, because including screens and all, because we had to have them laundered more frequently. And we had to have a backup when, you know, we were waiting for the laundered linen to come back in. You cannot really get rid of them, especially if there's moisture content in the air. And the same happens with clothes. So if there's moisture content with the linen, there is more chance of fungal organisms to be in it. But we don't test it because we're not looking at that being a source.
The ultraviolet rays. So if there are any leftover microorganisms in the fabric, even after the breathing is done on the fabric, so it has to be passed through the ultraviolet rays and packed separately as far as possible and brought back to the hospital. Laundry space, especially for processing, whether it's a hospital linen or hotel linen, you know, a lot more needs to be done in this space. So this is where our, you know, we as an engineer, we are trying to put in the processes in place, best management practices in place, and also bring in the certification methods for the laundry so that they maintain certain protocols in processing these linen. It's very important to have this. The world, people talk about sustainability, people talk about the prevention control, infection control practices being followed in the laundry as a day in, day out procedure. Yeah, so this has to be part of the routine job itself.